tremendous work of Christ because to recognize our sins.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to the everlasting life.
Soldiers abiding, they have taken power. You have broken the power of those who are not supposed to be able to. yet rescue them from the death of many of them. For us a child has been born, a son has been given to us. You will be our ruler. The same to you, the earthly advisor, the Father, eternal Father, and Prince of Peace. Eternal, the sorrow will never end, and peace will last forever. He will rule with David's kingdom, and make it endure strong. He will always live in prophecy and justice, the rule in all part of the world and serve him all of his time. Lord of the Lord.
Glory to you, O Lord. governor of Syria. Everyone had to go to their own hometown to be listed. So Joseph had to leave Nazareth in Galilee and go to Bethlehem in Judea. Long ago, Bethlehem had been King David's hometown, and Joseph went there because he was from David's family. Mary was engaged to Joseph and traveled with him to Bethlehem. She was soon going to have a baby, and while they were there, she gave birth to her firstborn son. She dressed him in baby clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. That night in the fields near Bethlehem, some shepherds were guarding their sheep. All at once, an angel came down to them from the Lord, and the brightness of the Lord's glory flashed around them. The shepherds were frightened, but the angel said, "Don't be afraid. I have good news for you, which will make everyone happy. This very day, in King David's hometown, a Savior was born for you. He is Christ the Lord. You will know who he is because you will find him dressed in baby clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly, many other angels came down from heaven and joined in praising God. They said, "Praise God in heaven, peace on earth to everyone who pleases God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
But my point is, there's so many songs about Jesus, And 2,000 years later, people still write songs about the birth of Jesus. So that's one important thing, right? Songs are very important. Just heard the kids singing a minute ago. What else? What else makes Jesus important? I want to see the hands of the kids. What makes Jesus important? Tell me, nice and loud. And Mama let it all out. She hired me. Okay, who else? Yes. Because he's our Savior. Our Savior means he saves us from our sin. That means he forgives us no matter what we do, even when we really mess up. How many of you in this church have really messed up? If you're not raising your hand, I'm not sure I believe you. We all really messed up, right? What else? Why else is Jesus important? Why else? Because he's God's son. God sends his son to live with us. Why? Because he loves us so much, God wants him to be with us. What else? What's something Jesus did while he was walking the earth? Yes. Go ahead.
You don't know.
Okay. What do you think? He died for us. That's true. What's something very happy he did? Maybe a doctor would do this for people. Give a little hint here. Yes. Philip. I didn't hear what he said. He gave us a new beginning. What else? What do doctors do? They heal people, right? They heal people. Jesus healed us. Why did he heal us? Because he loves us. Jesus is the most important person ever to be on this earth. He's God's son, healed down. Now, there are some people that have trouble loving Jesus. And sometimes the reason people tell you that is because they said, I can't see Jesus. He was here 2,000 years ago. He's this really old guy. I can't feel Jesus. I can't hear Jesus. But you know what the truth is? Jesus is in each and every one of us, especially the kids. Jesus is good, and he looks good in us. And Jesus wants us to share that love. He wants us to share that mercy, that forgiveness with everyone he encountered. My friends, big and small, that's what Christmas is all about. Today, we celebrate the greatest birth that ever took place, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ brought peace to this earth. He brought joy. He brought healing. He brought forgiveness. He is our Savior. So our job at Christmas time, yes, is to have fun with family. Yes, to give presents and eat cookies. I did some today. That's all great stuff. But the most important thing we're going to do today and every day after is share the love of Christ with everyone. Merry Christmas to you all.
Thank you. at your hands. We pray the glory of his name for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Thank you. Thank you.